Hi guys, Reaper here, thanks for tuning in. So I'm in my Raven, going out to see some of my corpmates, and I've agreed to do some PvP to test their ship. First off, we're going to try a Scorpion, which is a ship that's purpose-made to disrupt missiles. As you can see here, we've got three Kaldari Navy missile disruptors. My corpmate seems to think this ship's a good idea, however, I'm not too sure. And you can also see my Raven fit with the large rapid launchers. This is my PvE fit, actually. There's no change. I've got double webbers. I think in a real PvP situation, I would drop one of my ballistic control units for a cap battery so that I'm a lot more cap stable. So there'll be three of my corpmates in this video. We've gone to a low sec system. Of course, we're on the live server. And I'm just about to warp in to the Scorpion. Now the Scorpion is afterburner fit. It's going to be an up close fit, and we're going to see just how effective that missile guidance disruption is. If anybody's thinking about going out in a Scorpion and using it for some small scale PvP, specifically against some battleship missile ships like the Raven or perhaps the Typhoon. So I am optimistic, but we're about to find out what happens. So just landing now. I will also have a corpmate in an Ashimmu and a Vigilant to test against some cruiser ships that are using afterburners. So there he is, the Scorpion's right there. Just going to make sure we're good to go. Got two other guys on the way. Just see if he's good. I think he's burning away, so I think he's good to go. We're going to get this started now. So yeah, let's watch this fight and see how it goes. I'm hoping that the double webs will do the business, as well as my faster ship velocity bonus. Of course, if the Scorpion had a micro warp drive and knew I was coming in this fit, he'd probably specifically fly to kite me and render me inoperable, but this is kind of a like-for-like test just to see what we can do. So, yeah. My damage is pretty bad to start with because he wasn't webbed and he was a bit further out. I did check and my range is 13k with his three disruptors going. Here we go. Or in this case, we do stop. Freeze asked me to. So yeah, we were fighting to get the shields down in this battle. So yes, I think that proves the point that the Scorpion doesn't really fulfill a purpose. I mean, I can't make the ship work in PvE. I can't make it work in PvP. So yes, if you want to buy a Scorpion, that is your choice. But you've seen it here first. Right, so we've got a couple of corpmates. Got an Ashimmu and we've got a Vigilant, both are cruisers. I'm gonna fight the Ashimmu first. Just as a little disclaimer, this particular Ashimmu is fit to fight other Ashimmus, so he doesn't have a neutralizer but has two Nosferatus. He's also more geared towards kiting, but for the sake of this video and the fact that he's very small and very agile, we're gonna start close together. I'm gonna actually get my double webs on him. And yeah, he's shield tanked with a large blue booster. And as you can see, I am hitting him very hard and very fast. I've got both of my ballistic controls running. So yeah, he is going, yeah, he's gone. Yeah, better stop. I'd say that's, if I kept going, that is one dead Ashimmu. So we'll stop there and we'll reset and try fighting at his optimal or outside of my double web range to see what difference that makes shortly. That was, that was very quick. I have to say, I didn't expect that. That is just insane, the amount of damage I was putting out on a cruiser, given he was double webbed and within my optimal. But I'd imagine that should be, well, three times less if he's sitting outside of my web range. But just need to recall my drones, make sure we're not killing this Ashimmu. And he was saying, so Sky was saying that he couldn't rep enough to keep up with the DPS output there. And yeah, my Raven has 2K DPS hot running both of the BCUs. In 3 days, I would have trained Large Missile Operation 5, which with the ship bonuses will give me a 5% bonus to the reload time or activation time and damage. So that's 10% more, which means I'll have more damage whilst being able to take out a ballistic control unit and swap for a cap battery. So yeah, this Raven fits more geared towards some burst damage. But next up, we've got the Vigilant. So yeah, my corpmate was, missile guidance disrupted me there. So so with the Vigilant, he's got a 90 or 99% web, something crazy. And I want to start at a closer range, like I've just walked in and landed at zero. It does take my Raven probably 3 or 4 seconds to lock down a cruiser. But that being said, I should be able to get him in the webs, I would imagine. So we're going to test both ways, him at his optimal and, yeah, up close to start with. So just trying to persuade Nexus to come a bit closer. I think he'll get the point in a second. I am ready to go. So I'd like everyone to kind of comment on this and let me know what you think, but I'm very impressed with the Raven's PvP abilities and also PvE. I just think this is an absolutely cracking ship to use, and it'll be a great first ship for any pilots to get in. And it's quite quick to skill up to have really high DPS. So as you can see, he's close. We're going to get this fight underway. Here we go. This Vigilant is an armor tank Vigilant and has, I think, 14k armor hit points, as well as a blue repper. So as you can see, yeah, the shield's going to go down extremely fast, and then we're going to have a bit of a fight in the armor. So I've got him double webbed. He's got me webbed at 99%. I've got him webbed at something like 80%, I'd imagine, or 75% with the penalty. He's burning away, but he's just literally melted. That was so bloody fast. I've had to turn off, and that's a win. So didn't think it would go down that quickly, and he's after burning away. He is doing some speed, but again, those large rapids being hugely effective using the double webs and the target painter. So yeah, I've also got the scrambler. So again, if I'm landing on anyone and getting any cruiser, I would say, within my double web range, it would be a pretty good fight. I think against a Ashimmu that's fit with a neutralizer to shut off my cap, if I didn't have the battery like I don't know, it would be a completely different story. But yeah, we're going to test it now, get everybody repaired up, and try again, get reset, and do some tests at longer range. Okay, so I haven't let my capacitor get up fully, and I'm engaging now the Vigilant at range. I think I should be able to take him out without the need of boosting my shield with my EHP, and it looks like I'm doing pretty good damage. With both of my BCUs running, that's doing about 700 damage every 2.8 or 9 seconds, which is a lot more than this large armor repairer is able to pull back, so it's quite inevitable that I'll be able to take him down. So although he's traveling fast using a micro warp drive, you can see here the damage application is fairly tremendous, so I think this is going to be a win. Yeah, really enjoying this Raven, and as you can see in this video, it's doing such a good job versus a cruiser. I didn't think the damage application would be this great. There is a lot of damage mitigation, but the fact is with seven of these large rapid launchers combined with their damage application and very fast reload time, very difficult for any cruisers to tank it. After this battle, we will engage the Ashimmu at range, Sky's Ashimmu. So yeah, I think pretty decent damage here considering overall. And as you can see, both my ballistics are about to refresh. Quite low on cap, but I don't need to use my shield booster. And see, my BCU is ready to go now, so if I activated both, that would chew through the remaining armor and structure very fast. So I'm going to stop this fight, call it off. I think that's a win. So yeah, really, really quite chuffed about that. Of course, a battleship against a cruiser is always going to be hard for the cruiser to take down with the EHP, but the true test, I guess, will be the Ashimmu, which is coming up. Just in case you're wondering what the fits are like, you can see here we've got this Vigilant fit with some C-type medium rails, C-type micro warp drive, a armor tank, pretty decent tackle, and a neutralizer. So he's going to sit at around 20 kilometers. The Ashimmu you can see fit with a large blue type shield booster, a shield tank, as well as two webs and a NOS. Now, a different Ashimmu with a neutralizer against this particular fit without my cap battery and the two BCUs would ideally win, but I would like to try a proper brawling Ashimmu heavy newting fit against a Raven using maybe one or two cap batteries. I think that'll be quite an interesting fight. So I've started now with the Ashimmu, and you can see I'm hitting him for around, hitting at Sky, should I say, for around 700 damage again. Seems to be similar kind of damage application with the Ashimmu moving at speed. You can see they're out at range. And with that large C-type booster, he'll be boosting around 900 shield every 6 seconds. And it seems like I'm hitting the Ashimmu for around about 600 to 700 damage every 3 to 4 seconds. So with my BCU up, that is going to be quickly whittling down the shield. And I think this is very much looking like a win. As I mentioned, if it had a newt, I'd probably be capped out by now and it would be game over for me. But if I were to, if I had better skills, my Raven skills are by no means maxed. I'm short of 300 or 400 DPS. So yeah, with some better skills and a cap battery, I'll look forward to taking on a proper newting Ashimmu, one that's not fit to kite another Ashimmu for PvP purposes. But pretty happy with this battle, and I've just activated my BCUs, so my damage has gone back up again, and the Ashimmu is quite low on shield now, still boosting, but I'm gonna whittle the ship down, and soon it looks like it's gonna go into armor. Whilst this finishes up, I'd just like to say thanks for watching, guys. And as always, it would mean a great deal to me if you could like and subscribe to my channel so you can see and be alerted to my future content. If you have any questions or would like to comment, please hit me up in the comments below. And yeah, thanks again, guys. See you next time.